Our first hymn is Once in Royal Naval City, which is number 403. Norma will sing verse 1 as a solo, and please then be ready to stand and join in for the rest of the carriage. 403. Thank you. be strengthened in faith, and receive the fullness of life he came to bring, who is alive and reigns forever. Amen. And now our special opening prayer. Welcome all wonders in one sight, eternity shut in a span, summer in winter, day in night, heaven in earth, and God in man. Great little one, whose all-embracing birth brings earth to heaven, stoops heaven to earth. Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with
you. And also with you.
We say together, Almighty God, to whom all Christ come, all desires come, and from whom no secret sounding, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, the first commandment is this: Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is the only Lord. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this: love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Amen. Lord, have mercy. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins, to be our advocate in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with all. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbor, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in the newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who in Jesus Christ has given us a kingdom that cannot be destroyed, forgive you your sins, open your eyes to his truth, strengthen you to do his will, and show you the joy of his kingdom. Amen. And for the first time for a few weeks, we're going to stand together and say the glory. Glory to God in our lives, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we pray. Spirit, holy light, to shine in the brightness of your one true light. Bring us, who have known the revelation of that light on earth, to see the radiance of your heavenly glory. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And we'll sit down for our first reading.
First reading is from Isaiah chapter 9, verses 2 and 6 to 7. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who dwelt in the land of deep darkness, on them has light shone. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder. And his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and of peace there will be no end. On the throne of David and over his kingdom, to establish it and to uphold it with justice and with righteousness. From this time forth and forevermore, the zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Alleluia, the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory. Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being, in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him. Yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become the children of God, who are born not of blood or of the will of the flesh or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of the Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Please sit down. The world hasn't been cancelled after all, has it? We did get some clarity. We are allowed to meet. We're allowed to party. Though we're asked to be responsible and sensible. I suppose time alone will tell whether that was a good decision or not. But in my mind, it raised the question, can Christmas be cancelled? Listen to the words of that lovely opening prayer again. Welcome all wonders in one sight. Eternity shut in a span, summer in winter, day in night, heaven in earth, and God in man. Great little one, whose all-embracing birth lifts earth to heaven, stoops heaven to earth. From a poem by Richard Crashaw. And I think the church has been very wise in hijacking it, because it is so beautiful, and it sums the whole thing up so well. It has a strong emotional effect, too. It answers the question, what's it all about? The mystery, the wonder, the wholeness of the thing. God himself coming to us as a human being, in that helpless baby, born in circumstances even more difficult than our own are at the moment. It had always been God's plan to become one of us. Several reasons for this. One of them is so that he could teach us by showing us what he is like. So experience him, his perfection, his love, in an accessible form. And you don't get more accessible than a baby. And so that he could experience us, what it's like to be human, our joy, our suffering, our pain, our uncertainty, the whole human experience. In a sense, it was taking us into God and bringing God into us. Much, much more accessibility. And experience, of course, is the big thing. We experience God. God experiences us. Now, of course, we can't fully understand the nature of God. And to be blunt, it wouldn't be much of a God if we could, would it? It is the essence of God that he is far superior. But we can understand and experience aspects of him. And of the two, I think experience is probably the more important. The Gospels tell us that Jesus said to quite a few people, "Follow me." And amazingly, they got up and did exactly that. Now, if you were sitting on a park bench and somebody walked past and said, "Follow me," would you get up and do it? Well, you don't look very sure one way or the other. You wouldn't, would you? No, of course not. And you have to ask yourself, why did they do it? Well, I don't doubt that there was something very special about Jesus. And I don't mean those, to my mind, irritatingly piercing eyes that Robert Powell had. Do you remember the film? "Well, I'm sorry, I wouldn't have followed Jesus if he'd stared at people like that." But I'm sure there would have been something magnetic about him. But I think it's more that these people were, in a sense, seeking something more in their lives. It might have been a hazy something more, but it was there in them, and it was strong. They were open to something better, even if they didn't quite understand it. It was real to them, and it was important to them. They were open to the possibility of experiencing God in a new way. For many of us, the possibility of experiencing God is strongest at Christmas. Being a baby, as I said, makes him accessible. You can't get less threatening than a baby. And as we get to know God, most of us realize that he isn't threatening. That opportunity to experience God, to open ourselves to him, to seize this special moment in the year, is something that no virus, no government, and nobody on this planet can cancel. But we must still be willing to experience God, wanting to experience God, and waiting to experience God, because it doesn't come to order. We have to be patient. And while we're patient, we have to remain willing, wanting, and waiting. Amen.
Father of the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth,
whose kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, and with the Father and the Son, who is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy and apostolic and apostolic church. We acknowledge by baptism the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. And we'll sit down for our prayer.
Response to Jesus, proclaimed by the angels, born of Mary, is, "Come and abide with us." Jesus, proclaimed by the angels, born of Mary, come and abide with us. Glory be to God in the highest, to our God who has come among us and taken upon him our flesh. God, we give you thanks and praise for your wonderful gift of yourself. Help us to know your presence in our lives and in our homes. We rejoice with the whole church as it celebrates your love for us. We ask your blessing upon any churches where there is oppression or persecution at this time. We pray for all who will preach the word and celebrate the sacraments today and throughout this season. We pray for those who will celebrate in refugee camps and prisons, or completely on their own. We remember those who would have liked to have been with us in our worship. Jesus, proclaimed by the angels, born of Mary, come and abide with us. We give thanks for the message of the angels, and we pray for peace on earth and goodwill among all peoples. We pray for all who are caught up in war or violence at this time. We remember the world's poor, the homeless, and any who live in fear or anxiety. We pray for all who feel neglected or unwanted. Jesus, proclaimed by the angels, born of Mary, come and abide with us. We give thanks that our Lord was born into an ordinary family and lived in an ordinary home. We ask your blessing upon all our loved ones and friends this Christmas. May we know your presence in our joys and celebrations. We remember all who have to spend this Christmas away from their homes and loved ones. Jesus, proclaimed by the angels, born of Mary, come and abide with us. We give thanks that Christ became human, that we might share in the divine, that through Christ is our salvation. We pray for all who are ill or unable to enjoy life. We remember those who are fearful for their future, or who are unable to cope with the present. Lord, may they know your love and care for them. Jesus, proclaimed by the angels, born of Mary, come and abide with us. We give thanks that you came to earth to lift us into heaven. You took upon you our life, that life should be eternal. We remember loved ones who have died this year, and those with whom we have spent Christmases past. Lord, grant to them the gift of life and joy eternal. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you.
Father, you made the world and you love your creation. You gave your Son, Jesus Christ, to be our Savior. His dying and rising have set us free from sin and death. And so we gladly thank you. With saints and angels, praise you and say, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We praise and bless you, loving Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord. As we obey his command, send our Holy Spirit that broken bread and wine outpoured, may be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. On the night before he died, he had supper with his friends, and taking bread, he praised you. He broke the bread, gave it to them, and said, Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. When supper was ended, he took the cup of wine. Again he praised you, gave it to them and said, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. Praise to you, Lord Jesus. We are doing it by coming from the back, up the center aisle, God our Father, in this night you have made known to us again the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Confirm our faith and fix our eyes on him until the day dawns and Christ the morning star rises in our hearts. Amen. And we say together, Father Lord, we give you thanks and praise. That when we were so far off, you met us in your Son and brought us home. Dying and living, he declared your love, gave us grace, and opened the gates of glory. May we who share Christ's body live his risen life. We who drink his cup bring life to us. We who the Spirit lives give life to the world. Keep us firm in the hope we have set before us, so we and all your children shall be free, and the whole of earth live to praise your name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. May the Father, who has loved the eternal Son from before the foundation of the world, shed that love upon you, his children. May Christ, who by his incarnation gathered into one things earthly and things heavenly, fill you with joy and peace. May the Holy Spirit, by whose overshadowing Mary became the God-bearer, give you grace to carry the good news of Christ. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. And our final hymn is number 354, O Come All Ye Faithful. 354.